For two centuries, the Shauna Corporation has used borrowed futuristic technologies to provide Traveller, Python, CG, Skyrim, and bikini videos for the subscribers of this YouTube station.
Oh yes, please. Don't forget to subscribe.
So this morning I wake up thinking, oh, I'm going to play some Skyrim. Instead, I spend 5 hours downloading new mods that I can't wait to try that just came out in the last day or two. And then I have to configure my computer to do yet more synthetic voices. That took some doing. Reading all the fine print. I had an issue here where that guy who follows me to Fort Dawnguard, he ends up dead. I think that's him. No, that's not him. No, this is the guy that waits for you at the door and says Isran's been waiting for you or something like that. Or Isran's inside. Anyway, so he gets killed, and then I've got two kinds of ash. I've got vampire ash, and I've got regular ash. And for the longest time, my Skyrim would crash whenever I would go into the fort and then come back out of the fort.
I hope the vampires try to attack us here. A lot easier than hunting them down in their holes.
They did try to attack us here. Anyway, so it took some doing to get my game to work. FEC came out with a patch.
Never should have come here.
And then here's something else going on. I didn't wait for her to properly spawn before I started beating on her. She won't fight back. Okay, let's try again. I think she was in the middle of a script where she wants to talk to another NPC. One of the guards at the barracks. And we were interrupting her scene. So we will try this again. And here's something else. This load, it keeps doing this. Like 5 or 6 times before it lets me load my game. SC's got issues.
Travel safely. It's dangerous out there.
This guy looks familiar.
Getting tired of hanging around talking all day.
He's got some new wolf armor. Looks kinda, I want to say it looks Iron Man-ish. And now he has a cape. He's all complete.
Thinking I need to train some more.
So that's part of the, the old Cloaks of Skyrim bit. I put that in recently. So now I'm going around adding cloaks to people that have already spawned in my game. Oh, great, and now it rains. Oh, there you are. Now, in theory, she's supposed to be aged because Serana drained her. So her face looks old, but her body is the wrong color. Her face turns white, but her body doesn't. So I don't know if that's always been the case with FEC. When you drain a body, it just changes the face color. I thought it changed the whole body to white. Anyway, so I reported that issue this morning. So maybe that'll get fixed or looked at. Because I'm using vanilla hair replacer. I'm using a face discoloration fix. So those could be having issues with FEC. as far as, you know, FEC has to know what hair you had to change it white, and I'm always changing my vanilla hairs to something else. Now what are we doing? Oh! So I'm getting ready to install wet and cold. Get dragons to die the way they do in LE. I don't like the way dragons die in SE. They all do that Alduin death pose. What manner of magic is this? So how to get... Is there a way to get back the LE animations for dying dragons? Is there a mod called Dying Dragons? So you can choose how they die. I don't like the dance of death that they do.
Mom says I'm getting a new mommy and daddy, so I'll have what two is it each or? Now.
Mm-hmm. I heard the gourmet is hiding out somewhere
you guys,
in Skyrim.
You know, no one's impressed by that cookbook.
If it's a duel you seek straight, I am not here to fulfill your desire for pain or free
until
you from
next
your
time.
Wretched existence.
No one cares that I killed a dragon just now. And then this guy here, he keeps running up the stairs to talk to,
You've done us a great service.
Nenya. And then he never leaves. He refuses to leave. He just hangs around and keeps getting bounties from her. Anyway, so right about here is, I think I installed, or I removed hypothermia.
Good. Yes, what is it that you want?
And put in the
excellent. You've done us
wet
a
and cold
service. Here is your reward. Come and see me again sometime.
Because I heard after 6 years, I heard that wet and cold finally works for SE. So I thought, you know what? I'm gonna give it a shot. They fixed it. Someone fixed wet and cold like 2 months ago. Can you imagine? I serve under Jarl Sigurd, having a buggy as hell wet and cold for SE.
The Jarl has put out a bounty.
There's already one for LE.
Take a look at this decree for details.
That finally works, and then they finally got one to work for SE. I'm shocked.
May wisdom forever light your path.
Yes, yes, I haven't got all day.
So since it works now, mostly in combat settings. When you're during combat, everyone's putting on and taking off their hoods, their capes, their backpacks. You know, whenever the weather changes during combat, you have these issues. And they fix that, finally. Because I felt like having my NPCs wear, you know, clothing appropriate for the weather. And I miss backpacks for some reason. I don't know why. I want NPCs to wear backpacks when they're out traveling.
We'll show those faithless dogs.
So I thought I'd pay this guy a visit. I couldn't remember what armor he wears. If it's immersive armors or if it's storm cloak armor replacer. I think he's wearing immersive armors. Got some guards following me.
Do you need something?
The MCM menu came up right away when I installed wet and cold. I didn't have to stand around for a day waiting for the MCM to trigger. It just worked. So that's a good sign. When an MCM menu comes up right away, first time. That's a well-written mod. Anyway, so I'm trying to reset my followers now. I have to reset them pretty much so that they work with wet and cold. It's taking off their existing capes and hoods, and then I have to unfollow them and refollow them so that they'll know they'll know what's going on, and then I have to change a cell, go to a different cell, to actually initialize their new scripts they've got clinging onto them.
Next Imperial I see is dead.
If I'm doing it in small increments, baby steps, instead of just doing it all at once, all the settings for wet and cold, I'm just trying out each setting one at a time to see which ones work, which ones don't. Because you still got these chuckleheads on Nexus saying how they turned something off in the MCM menu, but it's still enabled in the mod, and they can't figure out how to turn it off. So I'm trying to weed out those issues from the get-go. If I turn off dripping feet, will it turn off the dripping feet, or do I still have dripping feet? You know, that sort of thing. So I'm toggling on and off each little setting.
Damn faithless.
In wet and cold, so far everything worked perfectly in wet and cold. I was astonished.
Faithless dogs who this land belongs to.
And I forgot I had the key to this guy's house, so I just come in here and grab his stuff. Free stuff.
Good job out there.
Okay, so Saran is all dressed up for wet and cold.
Hey, you wanna play a game?
But Rigmor's she's using a different follower scheme. So I have to be more patient with her. And Saran is wearing a wet and cold hood instead of her own hood. So that's good, that works. So I was curious if she would end up with two hoods on, overlapping each other. But she's using the one from wet and cold. And it turns out, I haven't seen her wear her old hood since putting wet and cold in the game. She's always wearing a wet and cold hood. But then we haven't been in really good weather for her to just throw on her existing hood. And if I don't see her wear her hood ever outside, then I know that wet and cold probably gets rid of it. So it might not be a thing in my game anymore.
This must be that beautiful Skyrim weather I've always heard about.
Yes.
What is it?
So I'm just looking at NPCs, see what they're wearing.
What do you need?
This always reminds me of the ending of Solaris, the 1971 version of Solaris. I don't know why. I won't say what it is because of spoilers. It has something to do with
my eyes open. Damn dragon.
There's no shelter from rain on porches and underneath roofs. The rain just comes through. Okay, now I gotta see how snow works with wet and cold. I need to find a place that's gonna have a snowstorm of some kind.